talking the last 20 years, 15 he's playing status and current team.
Okay, I thought you said the last 30 years, so I was extending out a little bit, because I was going to go MJ, Pippen, and Rodman.
Paragraphs 1 and 2, question. What will it's understandable that we occasionally feel discouraged. A number of Jehovah's servants in ancient times felt that way. Some even wanted to die. But time and again, Jehovah, the God in whom they trusted, reassured and strengthened them. Their accounts were recorded to comfort and instruct us. In this article, we will consider some servants of Jehovah who endured encouraging trials, namely Jacob's son Joseph, the widow Naomi and her daughter-in-law Ruth, the Levite who wrote Psalm 73, and the Apostle Peter. How did Jehovah strengthen them? And what lessons can we personally learn from their example? The answers reassure us that Jehovah is close to the brokenhearted, and he saves those who are discouraged. Psalm 34:18 in footnote. Joseph endured cruel injustices. Paragraphs 3 and 4. Question. What happened to Joseph when he was a young man? Joseph was about 17 years old when he had two dreams, both of which were from God. These dreams indicated that Joseph would one day hold a position of respect in the family. But soon after Joseph had the dreams, his life changed drastically. Far from showing respect for him, his brothers sold him into slavery. He came to be in the household of an Egyptian official named Potiphar. In short order, Joseph went from being a cherished son of his father to being a lowly slave of a pagan court official in Egypt. Then Joseph's troubles were about to get worse. Potiphar's wife falsely accused Joseph of trying to rape her. Without investigating the charges, Potiphar had Joseph thrown into prison, and he was bound in irons. Imagine how the young Joseph must have felt to be falsely accused of attempted rape, and think of the reproach that accusation might have brought on Jehovah's head. Surely, Joseph had reason to feel discouraged. Paragraph 5, question. How did Joseph overcome discouragement? While a slave and later in prison, Joseph had limited options and freedom of movement. How could he keep his balance? Instead of focusing on what he was no longer able to do, he diligently applied himself to the work he was assigned to do. Most of all, Joseph kept working with the most important person in his life. In turn, Jehovah blessed everything Joseph did. And that's the question. How did Joseph have been comfortable by his Jehovah as our rock or refuge, we will not lose heart or stop serving him. 1 Peter 5:10 reads, "But after you have suffered a little while, the God of all undeserved kindness, who called you to his everlasting glory in union with Christ, will himself finish your training. He will make you firm. He will make you strong. He will firmly ground you." Recall, too, that Joseph may have been about 17 when Jehovah dealt with him in a special way. Obviously, Jehovah has confidence in young servants of his. Today, many young ones are like Joseph. They, too, have faith in Jehovah. Some of them have even been unjustly imprisoned because they would not compromise their loyalty to God. Paragraph 8, question. What happened to Naomi and Ruth? Because of a severe famine, Naomi and her when they harvested a crop, they were to leave the edge of the field unharvested for the poor to eat. So Naomi and Ruth did not have to beg for food. They could obtain it in a dignified way. Paragraphs 11 and 12. Question. How did Boaz give Naomi and Ruth reason for joy? The owner of the field in which Ruth gathered grain was a wealthy man named Boaz. He was so touched by Ruth's loyalty to Naomi and by the love she was showing her mother-in-law that he repurchased their family inheritance and took Ruth as his wife. The couple had a child whose name was Boaz. He became the grandfather of King David. Imagine Naomi's joy as she held little Boaz and poured out her thankful heart to him. But the best yet to come to Naomi. Surely in vain I have kept my heart pure and washed my hands